sports. It's in the game.
Choose the team you want to start your franchise with. Choose the team you want to start your franchise with. Continue ahead to begin your franchise. Use the options on the left to edit leagues.
It's the sixth time in franchise history the Panthers have matched up against the Texans. Houston looks to tie the series with the win on Thursday night primetime.
And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25.
So out come the Texans for their opening drive.
They'll be led out by their now 36-year-old quarterback, who's in his 14th NFL season, the former MVP, Matt Ryan.
And he's had good success here already this season throwing the football. Six touchdown passes in his two games. He's really got this offense playing with a lot of confidence, trying to establish himself early as a Super Bowl contender.
To throw once more on second and 10, Ryan toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch.
And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, he's been doing this for more than a decade now, showing that he's still got that arm strength from back when he was the number one overall pick.
Well, one way or the other, you knew they'd have to push the ball downfield on third and long. But I'm not sure the defense is expecting to push it that far downfield. Their math didn't add up, but it certainly did for the offense.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Now Ryan. His throw incomplete. He was in search of his tight end, Tyler Higbee, and it's third down. Now Ryan. Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to about the 19. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
The coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
Blankenship's kick is good.
It's now 3-0, Texans.
Had just the one big play on the drive, but that was enough to put him in field goal range.
Yeah, one big play of what they hope will be many others throughout the game. Every team has a different target for the number of plays like that, those explosives that we talk about. That allowed him to put points on the board on that drive. Let's see how the rest of the game goes.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Here's a run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, second and 11.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
On second and 11 now, Burrow finds his big tight end, Mo Alie-Cox. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a big start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Oh, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time, and that takes us from second to third down. Burrow looking to pass.
Oh, my God.
Incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
39-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. Winless to start the year at 0-2, and now they get the Thursday night game here in week 3. So, I don't know, does the fact that they're back out so quickly, Charles, help or hurt their cause?
I say unequivocally help, because you always want the Thursday game earlier in the schedule rather than later, just because the grind of the season hasn't really set in yet. But also, if they can get a win here, they get a mini open week, recharge a little bit, and carry some fresh momentum into the rest of the season.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. Shreds him with a stiff arm, and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Ryan. Over the middle and complete to the tight end, Hickman. Fighting his way through contact. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches
the end. Fucking word, dude.
A gain of 32 that time. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. They'll try to run it in, going option right. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. Here's Ryan to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line, and that's where the return stops. Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And not much here as he'll get it to the 11, maybe the 12.
That's the fucking saddest shit.
The numbers for Bell on the ground of the game last week. 13 carries, 62 yards, and a touchdown.
And now that he's playing a Thursday night game short week, you know he spent a lot of time in the trainer's room in the cold tub trying to get his legs back for this game.
And he'll be taken
what
down.
What is this shit, bro?
The end of the first quarter of play. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. On third down, Burrow. This ball nearly intercepted.
You gotta be damn fucking shitting my ass, bro.
A chance for the big fella, but he couldn't corral it. Fourth down, straight ahead. Burrow going for it on fourth. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it.
Yeah, fucking interesting call.
Inside the 15-yard line. On first and 10, it's Gibson. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive...
Oh, into a sea of defenders have intercepted.
Come on, Delpit.
By Grant Delpit. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. The 20. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6 for a Panther touchdown.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought that had to be? Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked up that pass?
The free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, oh, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
Shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. He lost two, and it brings up fourth. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. So here are the Panthers set to take over. They lost two straight coming in, but good news for them right now. They've got the lead and the football. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They'll come up now on 2nd and 1 yard. Running for the first time with a fullback, C.J. Ham. A gain of just 1 yard, but it's a first down. Now they go play action now. Burrow. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. 2nd down.
I'm looking at this. You trying to tell me I couldn't keep my feet in?
Because you remember the old days?
Hold up. I don't know.
Tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch. But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave him a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
They'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. Now Burrow.
What in the fuck?
Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick.
I don't get that. I really fucking don't get this. How, yeah. Fucking choke. Damn, bro.
Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. On 2nd and 11 now. Ryan. This one is Slayton over the middle. 2nd quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he
what the fuck?
And the defense not able to get it.
You got me fucking shit my ass.
Like when you realize the ball is loose.
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you talked about.
You got me shit my ass, bro.
He probably talked about his training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. It's down a few yards.
Shit my ass fucking with Tyler Higbee ass bitch.
First of their timeouts. as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Ryan. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Touchdown! Tyler Conklin. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Texans have retaken the lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Out is the Texans kick team as they'll send this one away. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together and maybe get the field goal range.
Bro, what the fuck?
First down there, but it's incomplete. Here's second and 10. They go play action with Burrow. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. The 30. 10. Touchdown. Kill an 80-yard touchdown, and the Panthers on just two plays have taken the lead. I think you can make a fair case for Tyreek Hill being the most explosive player in the NFL when he gets his hands on the football, and that was Exhibit A.
That's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath.
Oh my fuck!
Give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
I'm fucking pissing my ass off, bro.
And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going, as they will take over here with a little more than 30 seconds remaining. Now Ryan on first down. Throw right side, taken in by Gibson. He uses the football a second time, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the shotgun, Ryan. Sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney.
Signed in the offseason, Jadeveon Clowney. Everywhere he goes, people expect to see what we just saw. Him chasing quarterbacks and putting them on the deck. He's been around in this league a number of different places, but in each spot, the expectation is that he may get double-digit sacks.
And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week 3 matchup. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Come the Panthers, they'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. Hey, Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, it didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and get them.
Wow.
Guarantee you that those guys
will what the fuck? Fuck? This shit needs fixed by G.
They're passing here, Joe Burrow. He'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. Touchdown, Carolina. Tyreek Hill, 81 yards. And the Panthers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find them at the wide receiver position, and that was special there.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards and just give me a second here, because when he shifted it into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence is right there.
And the next-gen stats are going to tell the story, and wow, what a story it is. Nearly a full 23 miles an hour. One of the fastest plays on record, folks.
Gostkowski, the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away.
Kene Nwangu now out of his end zone.
Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. So here's the Texans offense now. They get set to start this third quarter.
And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Now he dunks this off over the middle. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
Well, they showed a five-receiver set, had the backfield empty, and lined the running back out to the left. Plenty for the quarterback to process both pre- and post-snap, but he was able to find his man, and it turns into a big play.
On first down, Ryan. Open man here is Conklin. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 16 more on that one and another first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Throwing again on second down. Ryan, and his throw is incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, and it's third down. Again, Ryan. Higbee secures it over the middle.
The fuck you doing? The fuck ass, bro. I don't know what that shit is.
Texans have cut it to within a score.
On that third down call, the goal was to get the ball to their tight end.
I'm sorry, I don't know what that shit is.
They got the first down. That was the gravy. He decided to take in the whole meal and rumbled in for a touchdown.
Out is the Texans kick team as they'll send this one away. Taken at the goal line. Oh, a good return up past the 30.
Good return, yes, sir.
On the return there, gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. Seems like the measuring stick for a receiver for a great game is 100 yards. Well, he's well past that, man.
And as man finds how he's getting him, that's what really becomes fun, because let's face it, they keep sending coverage at him, keep trying to put the pressure on, yet he finds ways downfield and finds openings. That's a really crafty receiver.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 11 yards and a Panther first down. Play action. It's Burrow. And his throw here is incomplete.
So, Mo, what in the fuck are you doing, bitch?
Second down. Burrow
goal throw.
The fuck is that shit?
Picked off by Byron Murphy.
Oh my god.
What the fuck is that shit? Oh my god. Oh my god, damn bitch. What the fuck was that shit? I swear Madden got fucking stupid as shit with this.
And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you more cautious this go around?
Who? Did you know how to fucking damn.
Just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch.
Oh my god, you got me fucking dead, my dude. You got me fucking dead, my dude. You got me fucking dead, my dude.
That goes as a gain of 37 on third down. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll give this to Bell running right. Fight forward for a couple down inside the 40. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Gets this one to Le'Veon Bell. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Burrow. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
The throw over the middle, taken in. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive. It just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. It's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3. This is where the ball goes anymore.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Bell. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Le'Veon Bell. His second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers are once again going to retake the lead. So it was the passing game that got him down here. But closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. And it'll come out to the 25.
Okay, stop, dude. Stop running too far.
And now out comes Houston. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter. And a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds and complete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target, but it's going to be second down. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. He goes to Lamb again. This time he's got it. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup. Here's Ryan. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Lamb. taking it across midfield and
inside the 45. This shit getting close to the action, but
it's another first down. Ryan. And his throw is going to be incomplete. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. For whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
Throwing again, Ryan.
Oh, what the fuck?
James. Touchdown, Houston. Richie James, 44 yards. And the Texans have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. A plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown on the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
This taken in at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. Now it's Burrow. He's got the tight end, Mo Alie-Cox. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it a second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On second and 7, Burrow. And this one incomplete. Too much
incomplete. I thought
that one, and it's third down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. To the right side, a complete to Jefferson. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And they've got a fourth down now in a game that, to be honest, has been pretty much everything we could have asked for. They'll go for it with Bell. And boy, this
go for it with Bell and you can't get fucking shit, bitch.
And he didn't get there. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this Texans defense stands tall. So they've gone for it twice now on fourth down in this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0-2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got to wait for this one. Might get radio silence back.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Gibson again. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. The Panthers going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Ryan to throw. And that is incomplete.
Let's go.
How about some applause?
Let's go, D.
They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. Fair catch called for and made right at the
29-30-31.
37 yards on the play with no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. So now the Panthers down by 4. A time, a huge factor. Throwing, Burrow. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he will take it across for the Panthers' touchdown. Tyreek Hill. His third touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead here in the fourth. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at 25. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Here's Ryan. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that, but that would have been a big play. But he can
yeah, that would have been a huge fucking play.
Throwing now is Ryan. Gets this to Gibson. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Ryan connects with Slayton. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Open man, Higbee, the tight end. Now he's going to get this all.
Can you not hit Higbee?
That one good for 20 on the catch and run. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. Here's Ryan. This is incomplete. Antonio Gibson, the intended target, and it's third down. Back to throw. He'll dump that off to Gibson, complete. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of 2 there.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one, got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. It may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone, and it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
And a timeout coming in. This will be their final one with 10 seconds remaining. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Again, it's Bell. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48, 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
So this one is over, a victory for Carolina, and they were booing, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I'll bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together.